Hi there, Steve Kaufman here. Today, I am going to do something different. I'm going to have a poll. I'm going to ask a question, and I'm going to see what the opinion of you, my viewers, is, or what the opinions are. Today, I'm going to talk about two types of learners. The vocabulary builder type of learner, which is, I'm an example of that, or, on the other hand, the vocabulary memorizer. And I'm going to explain what I see as the difference. And then I'm going to ask you to basically answer a simple question. What type of learner do you consider yourself to be? So, as you know from listening to these videos, I believe in the power of input. And I believe in starting out with sort of simple content and then graduating to interesting content, and exposing myself to a lot of the language and letting the vocabulary gradually build up. And I've often said that to me, the sort of simplest Gordian knot measurement of how well we know a language, certainly of our potential in that language, is the number of words that we know. So if any of you look at my statistics at LINK, you will see that in Russian, the way we count words at LINK, which is every form of the word is a different word. I'm over 90,000 words in Russian, 60,000 words in Czech, 30,000 in Korean, and I'm at 8,000 in Greek. And I know from experience that it takes a long time to get used to a language. This word count is sort of a measurement of how much exposure I have had to the language. And so to me, the main task in learning a language is to increase my comprehension, my ability to understand the language. I like to build up my vocabulary, and normally at 30,000 words or so, I should be able to start speaking and speak fairly well. I'm at 8,000 in Greek, so I have had the last few days some online discussions with my Greek tutor, and of course I find it very difficult. I can't find the words that I need, because when we learn a new language, a lot of the sounds seem similar. So, you know, in Greek, synethiso, synechisime, exilixi, exixisi, they all sort of sound a little bit the same, and it's very difficult for me to pull out the one that I need. I know from experience, you know, I'm not bothered by that because I know from experience that with enough exposure, enough listening, enough reading, that this will gradually sort itself out as I build up my vocabulary and I become familiar with the language. And as I said in the previous video, I nevertheless sort of, I'm torn between wanting to do better in my discussion with my tutor, which means I focus more on trying to nail down, trying to memorize, do these activities that we have at LINK, the flashcards, the multiple choice. I read and listen to simple material over and over again. I'm trying to focus in on a limited range of vocabulary so that I'll be able to use that vocabulary. So I do some of that, but I'm torn between that and then focusing in on, I have this ebook of the Greek War of Independence, 1821, all of that activity, which is interesting and which is giving me a lot of exposure and a lot of vocabulary in an interesting context. So I spend more of my time on that. So the question is, what is your approach to language learning? Are you prepared to be a vocabulary builder in terms of exposing yourself to a lot of content, listening and reading, getting involved with interesting content, and expecting that at a certain point, be it 20,000 words, 30,000 words, the way we count them at LINK, things are going to start to fall into place. You will still struggle when you start to speak, but very quickly you'll catch up. Or are you the kind of person who deliberately goes about memorizing words? And this can be done using memory systems like Anki, or spending a lot of time at LINK with our flashcards and multiple choice and all these various activities in the attempt to nail down what you have learned. So, which kind of learner are you? Are you a vocabulary builder or a vocabulary memorizer? My experience has been that an attempt at vocabulary memorizing limits you because there's only so much that you can actually memorize. And in my experience, I find it difficult to keep, to retain that in memory if I'm not exposing myself through lots of listening and reading to these words in a variety of different natural contexts. But I don't, I guess I am trying to influence you, but that's, so that's my prejudice. I'm very much a vocabulary builder, long-term, call it. I place a lot of importance on passive vocabulary in the knowledge that a lot of it will eventually activate. But I know there are a lot of people who are concerned about what they can say now, who are bothered when they have a conversation and they can't find words or they don't understand. And so they put a lot of emphasis on trying to learn, not even just the most common 100 words, but at least enough so that they can at least feel comfortable that they can express themselves even on a more limited range of subject matter. So there it is, the poll, the link to the poll is here. Go for it. Let me know if you are a vocabulary builder, such as I am, more of a long term. I've often in the past talked about the tortoise and the hare. I consider myself to be the tortoise. I'm a vocabulary builder. Or are you a vocabulary memorizer? You want to grab it and nail it down now. Let me know which you are and any other thoughts you have on this subject. Thank you for listening. Bye for now.